All right, I think I got this. I think I got this. All right, we got the music playing in the background. Let me start this over. Yeah. Yeah, it's the perfect way to start. With that Outkast, because that's how I was raised, that's where I'm from. So I always think it's official, or it wouldn't be official, if I didn't have some type of homage to the ATL. So we're going to do it like this. Right, this is the Ask the Game Monologues. Straight from, well, I don't want to bite off nobody else's concept. Then I don't want to say I'm just surviving, because we're not just surviving in 2017. We're thriving. So we call this straight from the thriving scrolls. Yeah, I think that's appropriate. And we're going to talk about a few things tonight. It's currently 2:16 in the morning, and I'm just as vibrant as this is good. And I'm going to be a little selfish with it, because this is more therapy for me than it is for everybody else. However, this podcast is for everybody else. I'm not going to be be humble. So I guess a better way to say it is, I'm not going to be fooling myself that I don't want this to grow. I do want this to grow. I want more people to listen to it. You know, grow audience. I do want this to be an answer to somebody's question. That's what we're calling this, an Ask the Game podcast. This is just not another hustle for me. This is going to mean something to whoever's involved. And when this concept first started, it wasn't just me. But at this point, it is me. But just to give you a little background, the Ask the Game podcast, where it came from. The concept came from a group of guys getting together. It was about four of us getting together, saying that we all had something to give to the community, and this was our way of doing it. The way the format was going to be set up was that we were going to have it at one particular location and host like a little spades game or whatever type of game, video game or whatever. But it was to, you know, the point of the matter was to get the guest, whoever was invited to the podcast session, to get them comfortable so that we can ask whatever questions we want to ask, and they will be comfortable enough to give us the answer that, not necessarily what we were looking for, but definitely we were looking for them to answer the question. And I gave you a little secret of the whole answer game format, but I didn't tell you everything, though. It's more to it than that. But you know, as time has gone along, you know, here I am. Because, you know, people are going to fall off for whatever reason. But that doesn't mean everybody's gone, you know what I'm saying? No, we're still rolling along. And hopefully those brothers will, or some of them anyway, will get back in the fold. And we can just make this thing happen, because either way, man, I have full confidence. that this is going to take off, because we're going to talk about some good stuff here. This is going to answer. This is going to be the answer for a lot of the community, for people out there. The beauty of the internet is community doesn't have to be just here where I'm at. Community is on the internet now. So, somebody in Bangladesh, South Africa, you know, Australia, wherever, could be searching for an answer to a question, that this could be the answer. That's what I'm fully excited about now. Being that this is the first session of 2017, we'll talk about 2016 a little bit. I'm not going to get into what I accomplished, but I will talk about what I learned. And one of the things I learned was about the power of habits. Okay. Habits for the good, habits for the bad, but just habits, how they can be created. And a habit is just creating a habit. What I've seen for myself is learning about the way I work. Because I believe you have to do that. You have to really study yourself. And for the past 5 years or so, I've really been studying myself. And I've created some bad habits, and I've created some good habits. And it doesn't take long to create a habit. They say it's 21 days, but really, really, I mean, if you want to, you know, get technical, 7 days can really make a difference. Do something for 7 days straight, and it'll really make a difference. For instance, dealing with my, you know, dealing with losing this weight, because I got to drop these pounds, and it's happening. But for a time, I wasn't exercising just for whatever reason. I was letting, you know, the day get in my way, and that's a habit. So for me to break out that habit, I just started little by little. Okay, I'm a big push-up guy, so I would just, to get started, I would just do a set of push-ups on day one. Just tell myself, okay, while I'm watching this TV show, or while I'm listening, or while I'm watching this video, while I'm about to eat this bowl of ice cream or whatever, do a set of push-ups. Just do one set of push-ups, and that right there, and it's not, of course, it's not hard to do one set of push-ups for that day, but being that I'm in the state of lazy habits, that right there can be hard to break. But little by little, I did that set of push-ups, and the set of push-ups turned into walking outside, running a few laps outside or whatever. And then you add a little bit of here, a little bit of there, and before I knew it, I was walking up and down Stone Mountain like it wasn't nothing, just off of that one day fighting myself to do that one set of push-ups, just like that. Because we're all creatures of habit. That's, I mean, you know, what I've seen, you know, when I'm being successful, I got a bunch of good habits. And when I'm down in the doldrums, I got a bunch of bad habits. you know, not eating right, not sleeping right, getting, so I mean, you know, when I'm talking about sleeping, I'm talking about, you know, going to bed, getting in the habit of going to bed at 1, 2 o'clock in the morning, and then waking up late for whatever I got going on. Eating late. Not drinking my tea, my herbs or whatever. The little habits like that, but they turn to big habits. They turn to big habits. Not writing out my goals. That's another thing. And even though I wrote the goals now, not looking at them enough. Those type of habits. I mean, that stuff there, the little stuff can be huge. You know? Which goes in procrastination. Well, I already talked about that, you know. That's what's I've seen. That's what kills the habits, the making of good habits is procrastination. You know, say I'm going to do something. Like tonight, I said I was going to start this podcast. And here it is, 2:26 in the morning, doing this podcast. I should have done this earlier, but what happened? You know, the football game was on. Okay, after the football game, X-Men came on. The big comic book fan. I couldn't resist, you know. Well, actually, I could, but I chose to watch X-Men. It was funny. I fell asleep watching it, and they replayed the movie, and I caught myself waking up at the second point of the movie. At the same point where I fell asleep at during the second movie. It's crazy, man. Habits, procrastination. They all play together. The little stuff, man. It's the little stuff that gets you. It's funny how life works out, man. But in 2017, we're really going to build on the lessons I learned from 2016, because 2016 has ups and downs. You know? Path of entrepreneurship. Well, I guess a better way of putting it is I'm on the path of being self-sufficient, totally self-sufficient. One of, I don't know if I call it a pet peeve, I don't know if I can call it a fault per se, but I've seen it, man. When I'm most successful is when I have total control. So that's what my focus is putting myself in a position of total control. Make things total control of how money comes in, how money is generated to run my life. Another control, of course, is what I put into my body. Control of who I hang around, not who hang around, but who hang around to me. And what I can do with the resources I have. You know, just total control. That's what I've been fighting for all these years. Let me change the song is away. Yeah, this is better. This is better. But yeah, it's total control. And, you know, that quest for control, to be in that state, has, of course, put in front of me some challenges. And, my habit has been